boys, please watch your language. There are sailors present. And it's time for a song. And if one of you guys don't sing, I'm going to.
Oh, no, not that. Yes, I'd rather listen to Valley than you. And I'd rather listen to Sinatra. Go ahead, Junior. Thrill the people. Boost him up to the mic, Fred.
Up. Up's a daisy, Frankie boy. I'll get it in. Hurry up.
When they begin, it brings back the sound of music so tender. It brings back a night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen. I'm with you once more under the stars, and down by the shore in orchestras playing. Even the palms seem to be swaying when they begin. Again is past all endeavor, except when the tune clutches my heart, and there we are swearing to love forever and promising never. What rapture serene. Till clouds came along to disperse the joys we have tasted. And now when I hear people curse the chance that was wasted, I know but too well what they mean. Let the love that was once a fire remain ember. Let it sleep like the dead desire I only remember. When they begin, the begin. Till you whisper to me once more, darling, I love you. And we suddenly know what heaven we're in. When they begin, the begin. When they begin.
That was Begin the Begin, sung by Frank Sinatra, and very good, Frankie.
Thank you, Rudy. Say, I'm a little tired now. Could I sit down, please?
Sure. Help Frank to a chair, will you, Fred?
All right, Rudy. Thank goodness you're easy to carry, Frank. You look like a lollipop before they put the candy on.
Now, fellows and girls, since that great American poet, Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, was born in Maine, we feel it only fitting we should bring you some sort of poetry this evening. So we're going to bring you some sort of poetry. Here comes our poetess now, Miss Mary Livingston.
Hi, gang, and thank you, Frank Sinatra.
Sinatra?
Yes, it's really a thrill meeting you, Frank.
Now, just a minute, Mary. I'm not Frank Sinatra. I'm Rudy Valley.
Oh, well, I just missed by one generation.
One generation. I may be a little older than Sinatra, but I'm in better shape than he is right now.
Gee, that's terrible. You ought to see a doctor.
I'll be all right. Now, Mary, how about that poem for the servicemen and women from the state of Maine?
Okay.
What's the title of it?
Maine is on my brain.
Yeah. Maine is on your brain.
Also Sinatra.
Go ahead, read your poem.
Maine is on my brain. There are many Maines in this world so wide. Some are in the open and some are inside.
So far, nothing.
Wait till I get rolling. There's the water main which sprinkles the grass, and the main neath the street so filled with gas. There's a main street in every village, I hear, and a main on a horseway in front of the rear.
I can't make head nor tail of this.
Quiet. But of all the Maines I love the best is the state of Maine, away out west, the end.
All right, just a minute, Mary. Maine is our easternmost state. Honest, Mary, talking to you as a friend, I feel that I should tell you that your poetry is horrible.
Oh, yeah? I'd like to have a nickel for every tomato you caught in your megaphone.
Grapefruit. Nowadays, it would be called a victory garden. Well, Mary, here's someone you ought to say hello to, an old friend of Jack Benny's.
Who is it?
Fred Allen.
Old is right.
Oh, Fred, look who's here.
Hello, Fred.
Well, Mary, this is a surprise.
Where are you staying in town, Fred?
Well, I couldn't get into a hotel here in Hollywood unless I wanted to hop bells. So I went to a little auto court out on Ventura Boulevard.
How far out?
Seattle. It's quite a little place. It's just quite a place. It has a slogan, every room needs a bath.
You didn't have to go that far out. You could have stayed at Jack's house in Beverly Hills.
Oh, I know, but going through all that fingerprinting. A nickel every time I want to go in and wash. That meter on the roller towel. Oh, no, it's not worth it, Mary. Say, by the way, what do you hear from old easy come, hard to let go?
Waiting for Jack's first letter now, and I know he's going to be furious when he unpacks his bag.
Why?
Because I helped him pack, and at the last minute I had a change of heart and took back my girdle.
Oh, really? Well, the Pacific is a large area. He can spread out there. I hope he took his hot water bottle.
No, Carol Landis is with him.
Oh, a substitute, hey? Well, everything is ersatz nowadays.
Yes, and I'll knock his ersatz off if he doesn't behave.
What did you say, Mary?
But Jack did take some other things, Fred. Shirts, some pajamas, socks, and a hairbrush.
A hairbrush? For what?
Carolina's. Oh. The bag was full.
Oh, I wondered about the hairbrush. I know Jack parched his hair with a tweezer. He split it down the center, that one hairy. But tell me, hasn't Jack made a trip to the South Pacific before?
Well, he started it once years ago, but he didn't quite make it.
Oh, I heard about that. He got seasick, and Magellan put him off at Cape Horn.